Hi everyone. A previous topic we discussed about egg cookery, and as per the their hotel management syllabus, food production syllabus concern, we are discussing one by one topics which is related to food production subject and hotel management catering technology students, for the catering technology students. So today we are going to discuss about fish and shellfish. There are so many varieties of fish and so many varieties of shellfishes are there, and every fish we need to know how to select the fish, how to cook the fish, and what are the name of the fish and the body structure of the fish and the order of the fish and the method what we can apply to the fish. These all things we need to know about before cooking the and selecting of the fish. So with 30,000 of species of in the sea, it's a very difficult to remember each and everything. So that's why we classified into fish into the two types. One is fish, another one is a shellfish. So when you're talking about fish and shellfish, due to increase the demand, improved preservation, okay, all many fishes are going to be preserved in the frozen and in the deep freezers, minus 18 centigrade temperature, and we dress the fish, we clean the fish, and we make the cuts of fish, different types of cuts we are utilizing in the kitchen, and making of the deboning. All these things, when we do the processing of the fish and we preserve the fish in a appropriate packages and the hygiene conditions and the proper temperature. So many fishes and shellfishes are expensive. So some of the fishes are really very expensive, and it is very hard to get the fish in the market as well. So that's why we cooking methods also generally short, and we keep it very crispy and gentle, smooth cooking methods we use. And we need a special attention to when you're cooking the fish, because the fish flesh will be very soft and the tissues are very soft. That's why all fish products, the classification we called is a white meat, because they doesn't contains any red meat. The only few fishes are there red meat, which is a salmon, red salmon also. Other fishes are there, but we consider as a mostly that is also in a white the flesh, white meat. So structure and molluscal composition, and we have as per the classification, we shellfish also we classified into two. One is a molluscas, another one is a crustaceans. Molluscas contains a very hard shells. Crustaceans contains a very soft shells. Fish includes a freshwater, saltwater variety. The fish has a skin and internal skeletons of bone and cartilage. So these all things will be according to the classification of fishes. We divide into the different categories: round fish, flat fish, and freshwater fish, seawater fish. And fish is also classified into two categories: lean fish, fat fish. So these are called as a classification of fish. So how many types of fishes do we have? So in Indian cooking, Indian method of cooking, we don't have a much varieties of methods of cooking. We have the curry, we have a shallow fry, we have deep fried. These are the methods we have in our cooking. So, but apart from these, we have so many variety of fishes to follow the methods of cooking. So classification in three classifications we have fish. One is fish, molluscas, crustaceans. As I said, three categories. Fish will be freshwater fish and saltwater fish, lean fish, fat fish, round fish, flat fish. Round fish.
swims in a very vertical position and eyes on both sides for their head, truly round. It is a shape in round, that's why we call it is a round fish, a flat fish, bottom devilers, and found in a deep oceans. The flat fishes are the bottom devilers, and these fishes will be found in a very deep in the sea. So round fish and flat fish, the sea fish, seawater fish, and freshwater fish also will be there. That is we discuss later. And in the Indian, the fishes what we mostly we see is we have a Rahu, Katla, and Merrill, and Pomfret, and some swordfish, and sea fish, and some eel fish. Well, these are the varieties we get in the Indian market. But apart from this Indian market, when you go to the American fish and European fish varieties, we have a grouper, we have a sea bass, we have a black sea bass, the tilapia, and the catfish, and the halibut, and we have mockfish, we have turbot, we have the sea fish, we have jardines, we have the swordfish. We have a different varieties of the fishes. Those fishes are little expensive fishes. And how to select the fish? Fish, we know how to select the fish. That is the freshness of the fish. Gills we see, that is those gills should be red in color. Eyes should be in a bright in nature. And the scale should be a stiff in nature. And the body should be a frim. And the odor should be strong. So these are the basic the requirement to select the freshness of the fish. And bone structure. Some single bone will be there. Some fishes have a lot of bones. So according to the structure of the bone and flesh, constructive, and we decide the fish, how the fish is going to be cut into different shapes. Whether it's a fillet, or whether it's a darin, whether it's a gujon, different kinds. And molluscas. When we're talking about the molluscas, molluscas contains a very strong cells and the shells. These strong shells will be, you know, you have to use a different the tools. So for making of the fish and cutting of the fish and fillet of the fish, how we use a fish knife and flat knife or some of the chef knives. In the molluscas also, we need a different tools to remove the hard shells. So inner side of the flesh, we can use for preparation of the food and the soups and salads and starters and appetizers, are those, and the main courses. And molluscas are characterized by the soft and the segmented body within no internal skeletons. Only outer shell will be very hard, but the internal very soft, no skeletons. Three types, universal, one shell, and bivalves, two shells, cephalopods, pen or cattle bone. So these are the classified into molluscas. And the only harder part shells will be hard, inner shells will be very soft. Crustaceans. These crustaceans have a different types of the varieties. And in these crustaceans also, we have another classification. There's hundreds and hundreds classifications are there. But those all things are to know, remember, and names and everything is quite difficult. That's why we just simplify and I tell you only few names. Those have a hard outer skeletons or shell, joint appendages, and includes lobster, crab, shrimp. Lobsters, crab, and shrimp, and crayfish also come under crustaceans. So the round fish, the variety of round fish. So so far we discussed into three classification. Those are the three classifications of fish, crustaceans, and molluscas. So now the fish, what are the varieties we have the fish? So we have varieties of the fish, bassa fish, catfish, sardine, codfish, mackerel, Atlantic cod, mahi-mahi, and pollock, and red snapper, eel, black sea bass, grouper, striped bass, herring, hot dog, mockfish, Pacific cod, orange rugae. So these are the round fish category it will come, and these round fish will be mostly the freshwater fish and seawater fish also there. Round fish. So some more round fishes are there. What are those round fishes? We so far did that. And some more round fishes are salmon, Atlantic salmon, chink or kingfish, king salmon, and silver salmon, sea bream and shark, swordfish, tilapia, trout, tuna, wahoo, whitefish. These all comes under the round fish category. And every fish contains a different structure, different shape, different odor, different the flesh or tissue connectivities. And round fish example here, striped bass, catfish, mahi-mahi, mockfish. See how they look like. These, when you go to the market, the fishes look like on this shape, this structure. So pollock, grouper, mackerel, sardines. Okay, see how these fishes are looking very clean and clear. So while you're making the selecting of the fish, what we check, we have to check the freshness, then we cut into different names of cuts of fish. So in India, as well, Darin cut, only round cut and boneless cut. These are the cuts we do in India, and making of shallow fry or deep fry and stew or the curry, that's all. And apart from that, we have so many varieties of preparation from Western cuisine also, French cuisine also. Round fish and the Atlantic salmon and the king salmon. See here, the salmon, the whiter part is looking very silver color, but when you cut this fish, red in color inside. The contents are very, very strong flavor, and Americans and Europeans will believe that this salmon will have a very highly nutritional value, and it is a very good for the heart diseases and medical values also. Now we have some more, the flat fishes. So round fishes are done, and the round fishes available in a freshwater as well as seawater. Now we have a flat fish. So flounder, English sole, petrel sole, domestic Dover sole, halibut, turbot. Okay, these all are flat fish. See the flat fish taste is absolutely very soft inside. Very, very soft. It contains a single bone only. Lemon sole, the French cuisine is a very popular. Fish manure, fish colba, and fish and chips. Fish and chips, sometimes we can't use it, but it's good for the French cuisine. Petrel sole, English sole, the Dover sole. These all are sole fish, the French cuisine popular fishes. So flat fish, another than halibut. This halibut fish flesh will be inside very, very soft, white in color. When you poach, when you steam, when you grill, the flesh will be a melt when you take into a bite. Turbot also, very, very soft, white in meat, very soft tissues. When the moisture method, when you apply this, it will melt in your mouth. And now, so we discuss about the flat fish and round fish and sea fish, freshwater fish and saltwater fish. Now we discuss about shellfish, univalvous. Okay, shellfish. Abalone, knock, this kind of a shellfish, we take out, it contains a very hard shell on top of that. We need a special tool. We need to scoop out, and we need to take out the inside flesh. Flesh will be very soft. There is absolutely no bone at all. Clams. So the clams, we get, it's kind of a shellfish as well. So the American clam chowder is a national soup of America. Atlantic hard shell clams are quags, and the soft shell clams. surf climbs, Pacific climbs. These are the climbs we get in America. This American flesh will be used mostly making of the soups and using in appetizers and salads. And the scallops, another shellfish name is the scallops. Scallops are very, very soft meat, inner shell of the pot. You have a round scooped dices. So sea cold water, largest bay cold water, average 70 to 90 count. Calico water, 70 to 109 count. It's a depend on the size where we get the scallops inside. 70 to 109 count. So the quality of these scallops also can be the grilled or stewed or the sauteed. We can use a different kind of method. It comes under the classification of shellfish. Okay, the shellfish again. Green shell mussels, cockles, mussels, blue mussels, green shell mussels. These, you know, according to the colors and the mussels will be the classified into different names. The mussels also contains very hard shells, and these shells, these mussels also will be used a garlic, a butter, and some herbs, and thoroughly sauteed and thoroughly stewed and thoroughly steamed. And we can use it making of the salads, making of the starters, making of the stews, making of the the appetizers. And shellfish, another one is oysters. Oysters contains very, very hard shells. The oysters also can be used for a preparation of starters and buffets. And it is oysters always will be served as a raw under crush of ice. So it will be very, it can be eaten as a raw, but it is a very soft and very glazy and soft. And those oysters can be eaten as a raw. But only thing is that the temperature should be very, very chill in temperature. That's why these oysters will be served under the ice. Atlantic oyster, Olympias oyster, and Pacific oyster, European flat oysters. See here, European oysters, how it is, the shell is, how tough it is, and Olympias shells. So sometimes it will be served in on shells only with the ice. Hama shells and blue point shells, flat oyster shells. These are the oysters. Oysters will be eaten as a raw. And then octopus. Octopus have, you know, the no bone at all, very crunchy meat and very tuber meat. And these meats will be mostly used grill method and fried method and the steam method and boil method, and for making of the starters, making of the salads, making of the some stews also we can use it. Squids, it's a calamari, we call it. Is the calamari contains a one single plastic inside. There is no bone at all, and we need to remove that plastic. Then we cut into deep-fried method, calamaris, deep-fried calamaris, the poached calamari, saute calamari, and it can be served as appetizer, main course, and soups, and salads. And crayfish, crabs. Crayfish and crabs will different. The crabs have a different types of crabs. You have a blue crabs, you have a milky crabs, we have a snow spider crabs, you have a stone crabs, you have a king crabs. So many varieties again, and even crayfish also have so many varieties, but the meat is going to be very soft inside, and the fibers will be tough. That's why we need to use right methods of cooking. Mostly the crabs will be used for a meat making of stuffing and the salads and starters. So these are the variety of the crabs, king crab, Dungeness crabs, blue crabs, snow or spider crabs, stone crabs. See here, the crabs, how they look like. Blue crab in a blue color, snow crab is in a light in a pink in color and brown in color. So these are the how the crabs will look. Take out the flesh from inside, from the shells, and we serve the flesh. And we, for the making, breaking of the crabs and removing of the flesh, we use different tools, as we use a chef knife, a fillet knife, a fish knife, okay, and steak knife. This kind of knife, when you're using for the crustaceans and for the molluscs, we use a different tools. Otherwise, it's a remove. It's a little complicated for removing the shells and meat from the crustaceans. And crustaceans, lobsters, the food which is very big in size, and grilled lobster, roast lobster, lobster in garlic sauce, garlic lobster with the butter sauce. So all these lobsters contains a very long, the heart, the legs and the shells. Contains the meat is a very soft inside. For crackling, cracking of the lobsters, cutting of the lobsters, taking out the meat is a very, very scissors you require and very, very skill you require. What are the lobsters, crustaceans? Main lobsters, spiny lobsters, slipper lobsters, longstein lobsters. Well, these are called variety of the lobsters. And again, shrimps, prawns. So shrimps in a white in color, lobsters will be little bigger in size, and these bigger size lobsters will be, and meat will be more in the lobsters. Okay, fish and shellfish nutrition values. We have a different nutrition values in every food. So in a nutrition value, as per the inspection of America and those people, we don't require that. A freshness of the any fish, crustaceans or molluscs or fish. Simple. Smell, gills, scales, and frame of the body, texture, scales, appearance, movement. These things only we need to. Eye should be bright, gill should be red, odor should be strong, scale should be stiff. This is the freshness of any fish you need to find out, check, and select the fish. Whole round fish market forms. Whole round, drawn, dressed, pan dressed, veal or center cut, steak or darin, fillet, butterfly cut, gujonet cut, papillet cut. Gujons, darins, papillet, butterfly, fillet, and darin, and pan dressed. These are the different cuts of fish we use in the kitchen. For every cut, we use particular method of cooking. In India, we use maximum darin cut, round cut, or the bone, the cubes. These are called as a fillet. The long fillet, when you take out the fish, deboning and making for long size fillet, that is known as a fillet. This is a darin cut. Storing always, the when you're storing the fish, make sure a minus centigrade temperature, frozen temperature, minus 18 centigrade temperature, and the deep freezers, you need to packed well and covered well and kept in the deep freezers. And applying various cooking methods, dry heat method, moisture method, steaming method, and poaching method, deep poaching method, shallow frying, deep frying, and grilling, all these methods you can use according to the structure and body of the fish. Okay, that's all, guys. I hope you understand the the fish cookery. When you're talking about the fish cookery in India, we will be having a so variety of the fish: rahu, katla, maral, pomfret, all these things. We use only darin cut. Sometimes we debone the fish and we make the fry, shallow fry or deep fry or the curry. And apart from that, you will be having in a Western cuisine, as I said, is the halibut, swordfish, sea fish, eel fish, and the mock fish, sea bass, grouper, snapper, sardiniers. All this variety of fishes also can be very difficult to identify. So if you have any questions or doubts, you can comment me. And you please subscribe my videos for your first year and second year, third year food production subject syllabus. And definitely it will be helpful to you to learn a basics of cooking and advanced level of cooking and the Indian cooking also. So far we are discussing only continental and selecting of ingredients and the Western cuisine. Now after this we are going to start the Indian cuisine. What are the masalas? What are the ingredients? Classification of ingredients. All these things we are going to discuss. Okay, guys. Thank you very much, and keep subscribe my videos and watch it and learn something. I hope it will be useful to you.